I think that you spoke eloquently for all three of you, and you gave a gold coin to Mr. Hathaway with the millage rate. I want to clarify one thing with the stats that were brought up. That was print media, not electronic media. Now, we will move to closing arguments.
Wait, can I answer that?
Sure.
I don't know if you want. I live in the unincorporated part of the county. Thanks for asking that question. We have something called MSDs, and see, Jack's giving a thumbs up. We have municipal service districts. We have our own taxing authorities, if you will. Call it what you want. It is. And I have to say, Jim, I've gone through three mayors trying to be annexed into the city of New Smyrna Beach, where I live. But it's not just me, that's neighbors. It's a whole process. But here's the deal. We have nobody to speak for us at the county council level. There's no mayor. There's no city commission. We are the low-hanging fruit, if you will, in the taxes. I share your pain. I totally agree with you. Maybe we can bring it back. I agree with you, and I would like to be annexed into the city.
And I'll briefly touch on base. New Smyrna Beach has signed a 10-year agreement with the county for JPA to do services, to take care of those services in unincorporated areas of New Smyrna Beach. And if you choose to come into New Smyrna Beach at this particular time, if you can, legally, by being a budding owner, you're welcome to come into it. And if an enclave is created, the county mandates that it comes into the city. So that's just one couple of ways that this is going to occur, but I'll echo what I believe my fellow candidates have already said, is that I am going to be your representative, just as the city commission and the mayor.
We're not there yet, but I'm sorry. I want to save you time for that. Earlier I asked Mr. Kennedy about what he thought his opponent's greatest strengths were, so as part of his closing arguments, he can expound on what their greatest weaknesses are and why he should be the next county council member for District 3. Quickly.
Well, those of you who know me, I'm not a real negative person, okay? And so I find difficulty in pointing out weaknesses. But if I must, you know, Mr. Hathaway, if you want to characterize it as a weakness, he served the city well for 18 years. I think it's time to embrace the next generation. And I think that his experience almost hurts him in that respect, although thanks for your service. I don't want to underscore that. Ms. Denny's, I don't know her very well, and I don't know what her weaknesses are. And I wouldn't put my foot in my mouth and say something that's not true. So I can't tell you what her weaknesses are.
Tell us what your biggest strength is.
I can tell you about myself. That's something I can do, and I might put my foot in my mouth doing so. But listen, it's all about the future. It's all about how our government is going to operate from here on out, or for at least from the last couple of years on out. The old days are gone. The economic bust of 2008-2009 has set a new course for government. It's set a new course on how people look at government and what their expectations are. What I believe I bring to the council is a vision of that future, a vision of how government should serve the people of the future. And I also believe that governments need to be able to adapt to change quickly and be ready to do more with less. Why me? I get things done. I don't like to waste time in meetings and doing things that never produce any fruit. I'm somebody that will reach out. I don't go along with the crowd. I am the crowd. I see things that need to be done, and I push as hard as I can in a way that's not controversial, in a way that people want to get on board and want to join the crowd. And that's what I do at the council. My biggest priority is streamlining the county government, reevaluating the services that the county government provides so that each one of us as citizens of this area and of the larger county can believe in the services that we're doing, and we can believe that each of the services that the county provides, we're actually getting a return on our investment. If it's an ocean center or a tourism development, let's make sure that it's working efficiently and it's actually working for the purpose that it was designed for, not just a white elephant tied to our neck. And that streamlining the county is my number one priority.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Mr. Hathaway, and right to the point.
Okay. Right to the point. You know, why is having experience a negative? I mean, I'll be thinking that if you go to a doctor who's brand new, wouldn't you rather have a doctor that's actually treated some patients before? If you went to a lawyer, wouldn't you rather have one that's been through a trial once or twice? I mean, I don't find that my 18 plus years as a city commissioner, my four-plus years on the Volusia League of Cities, on the executive committee, and now the president. My X amount of years, 15-plus years, actually 18-plus years on the Volusia League, on the Florida League of Cities, and my past 2 years as a board member. I mean, we're talking 434 cities throughout the state of Florida, and I'm one of 54 members on the board of directors. I don't think that's something that should be snubbed at. I think that means I've been recognized by my peers as having a leadership quality. I think the reality of it is you want somebody that's experienced to go to DeLand. You want somebody that can recognize who you need to talk to get things done. I mean, I'm the common sense guy in New Smyrna Beach. You ask, who's the guy on the commission that asks the questions? It's me. And, you know, I'm not tooting my own horn. It's a fact. It's reality. Anybody who's been to our meetings know that. So, you know, I don't see that as a downfall. I just look at my fellow opponents saying, I'm not going to slam them. I'm just going to say they just don't have the experience. They don't have the leadership ability that I've accumulated over the years. I'm proud to be a lifetime New Smyrnan. I'm proud to be a small businessman. I'm proud of being successful, and I'm proud of the accomplishments I made.
Very well done. I think I've been recognized.
Thank you very much.
One question. You're going to go to DeLand. Are you going to go to Oak Hill?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
I've been to Oak Hill. My niece had a farm down there recently.
I've been to Oak Hill. In fact, we're doing a community report that's up on YouTube on Oak Hill. And I just have to close with this because I'm grinning. I'm hearing Reagan, and I am not Reagan by any stretch of the imagination, but I won't use my experience and age against you. But here's the deal. When you send somebody to the Volusia County Council, you want leadership skills. We have that. And I agree with Jim. 18 years, 20 years, 30 years. They may be brandishing a gray hair a little bit better. You just can't see mine, thanks to Mary Kay or whatever it is. But I do have leadership skills and business skills that through elected office, through appointed office, through working in the communities, that I hope to serve you and be your voice should you honor me with your vote when you vote August 14th, whether it's absentee, early, or at the precinct. There's a lot at stake here. I will be your voice. I will visit your communities and continue our community report in the future. But please don't let age or experience be a barrier in who you're going to support to represent you. Thank you. I'm Deb Dennis.
You got about 3 minutes now to be had. The two experienced and the kid. The kid gets the last word. What about that challenging of that experience? New ideas?
I look out and I see my parents and my grandparents, and to them, I'm certainly a kid. There's no doubt about it.
That's nothing but affection.
Absolutely. You know, there's all kinds of young people in politics today. There's all kinds of young people that have stepped up to the plate and to do what people want them to do. And you're right, I won't use my age and experience over anybody.
You all did an excellent job. You were very kind to each other. I thought there'd be fisticuffs,
but you
did well. Thank you. We're going to take a 10-minute break.